Apologies for the not stellar audio quality. My main microphone is broken, but I wanted to make this video while it was still somewhat topical, so yeah, sorry about that. Anyway, so this non-profit called the Sandy Hook Promise released this ad that in 2 days garnered 1.6 million views. It obviously did pretty well, but by their name I'm sure it's pretty obvious what they're about, but let's have a look into the video anyway. So it starts off fairly stereotypically in a scrub-clean American high school with cheery guitar music as we follow Evan near the end of his school year. He starts scratching stuff on a table and soon an unknown responder starts writing back and they develop a rapport. I guess it's pretty cute in a student film kind of way, until the last day of school where he meets the responder and...
This is the guy that I was running to in the library.
Guilty. So you like to write on desks?
Yeah, that's what I do.
What the fuck?
Okay, first of all, don't try and use the bullshit twist ending on us. We already know who you are. We know this is going to be about school shootings, and plus, you made the focus on Evan, so fucking duh, we're not going to notice the background dude. As a matter of fact, I actually did notice the Instagram gun photo, but we'll come back to that. My main point to this, however, is what the fuck is wrong with you? Can you not see how this is an incredibly toxic message to put out to goddamn school children? Ignoring the Instagram photo for a sec, let's have a look at the apparent signs of being a school shooter. 1. Reading a gun magazine. If one has a hobby or interest in guns, make sure to treat them with immediate suspicion, because it's very much abnormal for adolescents to be interested in guns as a hobby in a country where there's 112 guns to every 100 residents. 2. Being kind of an antisocial dickhead. Remember, if someone is dismissive of you and acts rude, it's probably because they're a school shooter! This is especially true if they're wearing headphones, as they're probably listening to their Charles Monroe or violent hippity-hop music. Number 3. Being fucking bullied. Do I even need to make a joke about this one? Number 4. Watching gun videos on YouTube. Please see number 1. Number 5. Making finger guns at someone. Fucking put him in prison now, he's clearly a danger to everyone around him. Guess what? This kind of shit doesn't help prevent gun violence. What this starts is a witch hunt mentality, where everyone who is seen as kind of weird and probably already gets enough shit daily from bullies and teachers is now, on top of being ostracized from the high school social system, is seen as a fucking school shooter too! The reason this pisses me off, right, is because the antisocial loner this film seems very sure is a school shooter. Well, he's me, and people I knew. I was friends with a guy who was obsessed with guns and weapons, and guess what, he was one of the nicest people I ever met. And this dude, that dude here, that's me. That's how I was in school. I was bullied, I was disaffected, I hated everyone around me. Combine naturally introverted with people giving you shit for that fact every damn day, and yet you get someone who is very much like the guy here. I know Sandy Hook Promise's intentions were good, I know they don't really think every introverted loner is a school shooter, but this ad is treating like these people are textbook signs for them, which just makes kids who see the world very much still in black and white think that every introverted loner is a school shooter. Take that and add in how many school shootings happen and how often parents are going to tell their kids about it and how often they're going to hear about it on social media and on the news. Yes, some kids actually do read the news. Plus, how susceptible school kids are to advertising, and all you've got is outsider kids being treated even worse by their peers, which by Sandy Hook's promises logic is only going to make more fucking school shooters. Oh, and to address that Instagram photo, this decision just baffles me. It's true that attackers will often tell someone about their plan before they do it, but 1, it's normally to specific individuals, and 2, if it's not, it's not normally several weeks beforehand! I refuse to believe that a kid would scroll past their weird outsider classmate taking a gun selfie with the caption "See you at school" and have zero reaction to it, let alone getting them 56 likes! There is a rapport function, you know, there's a principal to tell, and there's fucking peers, you can tell. That is a telltale sign, they're right there, but in the context of the film, all it does is make the main characters look like complete fucking morons, cheapening your message even further. There are films that piss me off, but rarely this much because they don't really present that much of a real-world impact from their awfulness. They're just sort of bad in a vacuum. But this, I feel like it could have a genuinely terrible influence on school kids that see it, and given how many views it has in just 3 days, I'm willing to bet quite a few already have. If people don't call this kind of thing out, we're only going to see it get worse, because shock ads purporting to be truth can do just as much damage as good. However, given the fact that by the time I saw the video they had disabled the like-dislike bar on comments, people probably did call them out and they're just too much of a pussy to take the criticism. I guess we'll never know.
Right now.